Joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy. He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Doctor, thanks for being
with us.
Hey, good morning.
So it sounds like good news. Illinois, lowest number of hospitalizations in 3 months. COVID cases down nationally 60%. CDC saying still be vigilant. And I'm just wondering where you think this mask mandate will go and how we're trending.
Well, you know, it's better. But it was so bad. That's the problem. I mean, you're still talking about 1,198 new people still in the hospital here. And in the country, you have 1,369 deaths. I mean, it's like 5 airplane crashes per day. So we have a ways to go. If we start loosening up these mandates, the same thing that happened in August is going to happen in November and December.
We don't talk about it that much, but should we be concerned in the big picture about the global issue and the low vaccination rate there and how it could come back to affect us here in the future?
Oh, absolutely. Larry, this is a global disease. Now, the Europeans are ahead of us now. They were behind. They caught up because we had so much resistance to the vaccines. The Russians, on the other hand, are the biggest COVID country in Europe now. And they have the lowest vaccination rate, even though they discovered the first vaccine that got approved in August, Sputnik V. So it's really crazy all over the world. But you're right, this is a global thing, and until it's globally addressed, this is not going anywhere near away.
There's talk of a fourth COVID shot. Who is that designed for?
That's designed for the 2.7% of the people, 11 million people, who have a really severe underlying immunodeficiency. These are people who are organ transplants, kidney transplant, liver transplant patients, patients with some malignancies, especially the hematologic malignancies, and some people with HIV. So the really severe ones. So it's actually not a booster for them. They never really had a good response, and they may need 4. They may even need 5 or 6 doses.
All right, we need to get to viewer questions this morning. I received the J&J vaccine in March when I was very early on in my pregnancy. I am due within the next 7 weeks and wondering if I should get the Moderna booster. Is there any information yet on how this will impact my baby? Does being a nursing mom have any impact?
This is a very timely question. I'm glad this person asked it. I'm glad we brought it up here. Yeah, this person should get the booster as soon as possible, and they should take the Moderna booster, the 50 microgram dose. The reason for that, and it should be given at any time during the pregnancy. That was an announcement from the CDC about 6 weeks ago, because getting COVID during pregnancy is really much worse than we had originally thought. And the Moderna vaccine has other advantages in that it's A, it's more potent, and B, it doesn't have the blood clots associated with it that the J&J does. So she should take the Moderna booster as soon as possible.
All right, next question. My child turns 12 in mid-November. If the 5 to 11-year-old doses are released prior to that, should my child receive one kid-sized dose and then have a follow-up dose be the adult-sized dose?
Yeah, this is a funny question. Yeah, it's not really going to make any difference. There's no magic about turning from 11 to 12. So whatever they start with, they should just continue. Doesn't really make any difference if she waits 2 weeks and gives the kid the higher dose. It really isn't going to make any difference.
All right. Is there a company working on a COVID vaccine that works to the degree our other vaccines work, as in they actually prevent one from being infected? While I'm thrilled we have what we have, I hope something better is developed.
Yes, this is another great question. First of all, Pfizer and Moderna are working on version 2.0 that will address the issues that the Delta variant has brought and everything else. There's at least 80 other vaccines in development. Now, the problem is the mRNA vaccines, Pfizer and Moderna, were so good, much better than expected, that it's going to be hard for them to get up to that particular level. But, you know, there's a lot of work in this area. We've learned so much about vaccines and so much how to develop vaccines against COVID that, yes, there will be a better vaccine at some point.
Okay, if you didn't get your question answered, Dr. Murphy answers them biweekly on Northwestern University's Institute for Global Health Facebook page. You can also submit questions via email or head to our Morning News Facebook page and post one there. We'll talk to Dr. Murphy again on Monday. Have a great weekend.
Have a great weekend.
Thank you, Doctor.